What is going on, guys? It is HubertHockey42 here. Recently now, Hubert Productions. I call it Hubert Productions because Hubert Hockey was really just a name because my channel was recently mostly hockey, but since I changed and started doing more other videos, we recently now changed it to Hubert Productions. But nobody panic, because we are still doing a bunch of hockey videos. Like this one today, we are actually doing a... If I turn my camera over here a little bit, if you can see in the back corner, my stick collection has grown just recently. It actually has grown a lot. And by a lot, I've started buying composite hockey sticks. If you've seen my channel and seen my videos of previous hockey stick collections videos when they were kind of small or whatever, you could see that I only use wooden ones. I really only use wooden twigs. Because out in my shooting area, I have just synthetic ice or whatever. I didn't really need composite sticks. But until I recently started doing stuff involved with ice hockey, I've recently started buying composite sticks. So, we'll start with wooden sticks, but we will slowly progress to the composite sticks and finish off with one surprise stick. Okay, so, I went ahead, I pulled all my sticks over here. We will start with my first stick, as it's a CCM Heat. The story behind this twig, obviously the tape is new, but has been used. But, what I could say about this stick is this. It is very short, even on skates, very short. So, really, I don't like much about that twig. It's just too much. But, I will say, in my recent, where I buy my sticks, at one specific rink. I'm not going to give the name because of whatever. There's another CCM Heat, but if you can see the difference, number one, it's thicker. But there's also another difference. Height. It is taller. But there's nothing different, no compatibilities, nothing. Probably has the exact same flex, 85 P29 curve. Probably has the exact same as the shorter one. I don't know. The flex is probably shorter because that one's shorter. But I don't know. I mean, probably wooden sticks don't have any flex anyways. My second shortest twig, not counting that one, is Bauer I-3000. Again, like I said, these aren't composite sticks. These are the wooden ones. Typically your ones for street hockey. Yeah. Flex on this is 87.
Sorry, I'm not sure.
I'll get back with you in a moment. Sorry about that. I have a Amazon Echo device that rudely interrupted. So, where was I? 87 Flex, P92 Curve, power at 3000. Yes, I'm setting the sticks over the camera, so the camera jingles, that's why. Next stick is, we will work with this one, Shearwood 5000. Obviously, it was torn up, so I recently used it in street hockey. The 5000 PP09. At least that's what it says. Alright, so next stick is Shearwood T10W. I don't, like I said in the last videos, I don't know what the W means. But all I can say is it's got a PP26 curve. At least that's what I believe. This stick has been through a lot, as it's got some, actually I can show you right here. If you can see, it's got some major damage to it. So I probably got to take the tape off. But other than that, seeing how thick this blade is, I don't think it's going anywhere. So that's that toy. That's Shearwood T10W. Okay, Shearwood T10 regular. Like I said, I don't know what T10W means. This stick has a lot of nicks and dicks to it. Got a little crack here, actually. A little chip to it. Yesterday, I threw it. Yeah. This blade's a little chipped up because of yesterday. It's obviously not taped because I haven't been gotten a chance to retape it yet. Honestly, I probably have to retape all my wooden sticks. Final. That just fell. Final wooden stick. It's got ABS plastic on it. So that's how that is holding up. I have to retape it though, because I haven't retaped any of my wooden sticks, because I bring them to street, I bring them to like basketball courts, and so I don't really tape them, because it's just, the tape's just gonna get annihilated. But yeah, ABS Shearwood T20. Shearwood calls all their sticks with a T in it. I don't know. Of course, how can I forget these? There's two of them, that's why I have two of them. These are Mylac Eclipse Jet Flows. They're 53 inches. They are street hockey blades. So yeah, that's those. So now what we'll get on is what's left is my composite and the surprise stick. So, first composite stick. This was actually the first composite that I bought. It's a Warrior Covert QR550. Yeah, it's honestly, it has a 75 flex, but I have a shortened extender into it to make it at least a little bit higher. Yes, the sticks are taller than me, but I prefer tall sticks. That's just what I prefer on the ice. But yeah, 75 flex, Warrior Covert. First composite stick that I ever bought. It's actually really, really good on the ice. It feels pretty good on the ice when I use it. Next one I recently bought was Bauer Nexus. I think it's just a regular Nexus, old generation Nexus. Flex on this one, actually. It doesn't say, it says it ranges from 105 105 to 112. So I'm probably going to say 130 flags. I don't know at this point. So Bauer Nexus, that's the second composite stick that I've bought. Finally, on the composite sticks, we have the True A4.5. Flex on this stick, 95. Final stick is, yes, a CCM goalie stick with a 26-inch paddle. It's got a Price P1 curve on it. Yeah. I don't know why I bought a goalie stick. It was on sale. So, yes. So, as you can see, all of my twigs are there. That is all of them. And, yes, that is my goalie. So, guys, that is going to do it for all of my sticks. Probably for a long time. But I won't be buying any more for a while because I've already spent like $200 on just those three composite sticks. So this will probably be the last stick collection updated video. If you did enjoy this one and want to check out my other ones, I will put these in a playlist and you will see those there. If you want to see more videos, comment on my other videos, give this video a like and subscribe. And this is Huber Hockey, Huber Productions, signing off. Peace out.